Fede, un favor, ¿nos podrías avisar si empieza el peso mediano? A ver si nos podrías avisar cuando empieza el peso mediano.
Well, we made an offer, as you know, exclusive. Seckbach broke it last night. We asked for a meeting. It's very, very frustrating because, you know, some people say, oh, Joshua's ducking Wilder. If you look at the resume of Anthony Joshua, he's ducking nobody. We're making offers. We're trying to have meetings. And my dad got in touch with Shelley Finkel and said, can we meet early October to discuss the fight? He said, no. I said, well, how can we make the fight? Oh, you don't want the fight. He said, well, why are we asking to have meetings? We're not doing it to waste our time. So he said, make an offer. So we made another offer yesterday, this time a percentage. With a guarantee as well, hoping that we can actually get a meeting. I mean, I didn't know it was so hard to get a meeting with Shelley Finkel. We ain't got nothing else to do.
What about the an impossible fight with for the next year between Joshua and Wilder? The WBC says that the priority of the organizing is this fight.
Yeah, cool. And it's the priority for us as well. You know, I mean, Dillian White is standing by, and you know, we've put our case to them, but ultimately Brazil has been given a mandatory position, I think unfairly, but you know, it is what it is. So Dillian White is standing by to fight Anthony Joshua if Wilder doesn't want the fight. Obviously Wilder Fury has to take place first, but there's no reason why we can't have a deal in place for Wilder against Joshua, subject to him beating Tyson Fury, which I believe he will. So, you know, as we stand with the WBC in that our ultimate priority as well is to fight for the undisputed title, whoever is WBC champion.
Do you think that
Kerry Wedge needs
that fight?
Wembley, April. Joshua's next fight will be April 13th.
Do you think that
Kerry
Wedge will organize? How difficult is it to organize?
Very difficult, especially with the weather.
Okay, sure, yeah.
He's sold 350,000 tickets in his last four fights. So, you know, and it's every fight is a national occasion. Every fight is a spectacle. Every fight makes the entire world sit up and look at what this man is doing. He's the biggest star in the sport of boxing. So it's great fun, very challenging, but he's a great fighter.
What is going to happen with Chavez and Maravilla? You told me last night.
Well, I mean, look, you know, Julio Cesar Chavez talks a great game, you know, but no one knows the weight of Julio Cesar Chavez. So Julio Cesar Chavez Jr. called out Maravilla. Now, Maravilla was sitting on his chair at home enjoying his retirement, and something inside him said, I want to fight Chavez Jr. So I've been working with Miguel Maravilla and with Guadalupe Valencia to try and get this fight happen. But now they tell me that he will fight on the December 1 card. But I think Julio Cesar Chavez needs to either be quiet about Maravilla or take the fight. He's been challenged to the fight. So yeah, people say the fight is crazy, and it is crazy. But if you talk about the fight and you accept the fight and this man comes out, the deal is done. But does Julio Cesar Chavez want it? Everything is in Chavez Jr.'s court.
I talked to him yesterday, he told me he wants it.
Yeah, he says he wants it.
Yeah.
But it's there for him to sign.
Okay.
But instead he wants an easy fight on December 1, so...
He told me it's actually the contract with the other side.
No, the contract with the other side is done.
Okay, that's what he told me. Right.
Well, then someone's telling him lies. So you can tell him from me that someone's lying to you, because the fight can be signed today for Maravilla against Chavez.
So there is no fight for November?
Yeah. It's up to him. Sergio Martinez is here. We'll sign a contract today to fight on November 17th.
What it will be the fight? The fight is going to...
November 17th, Mandalay Bay.
How important is the American boxing for you?
Very important. We've just done a deal with The Zone.
Yes.
We do 16 shows there a year. Our first one's in Chicago on Saturday. It's a big part of our business now. You know, it's a huge market. It's very competitive. Everyone is going crazy. And it's going to be a lot of fun, but we're here. Got one more, guys, because I've got a flight to catch.
Is it either it's a good thing to have have Joshua in the ring?
Definitely, definitely. But the problem is that America has always been the place to go to make someone a star. That's not the case anymore, but it is important to his global appeal. He's not a huge name in America yet. Okay, he's obviously a huge name around the world and in the UK particularly. But we have to explore other markets as well, not just US. You know, China, the United Arab Emirates as well, Africa, lands in Joshua. He's capable of doing it, but you know, we do need to fight in America at some point. But it's very difficult to leave when you're selling 90,000 tickets and your country loves you.
Finally, Billy Joe Saunders and Demetrius Andrade, what is going to happen?
It's before the Massachusetts Commission on Monday. Okay. I mean, he's failed a VADA test under certain regulations like UCAT and WADA. In competition is defined as in other ways,
yeah.
But it's, we can't do anything, Saunders can't do anything. It all depends on the Massachusetts Commission and whether they will license him for the fight on October 20th.
Thanks so much.
Thank you. Thank
you.
Yes.